How's it going, guys? Welcome to the FM Dugout, and we are back with another episode of Rescue Rangers, where it's match day 4 in the Europa Cup Group E, and we take on West Ham at Ibrox tonight, where a win will see us get through to the knockout stages. Obviously, we lost 2-0 down in London, but since then, we have done fairly well in the group stage. We have drawn away from home against Shakhtar, and we have beaten Bursaspor and Shakhtar at home, sitting on 7 points for tonight's game. Let's just remind ourselves of that group. And you can see West Ham have really been running away with it. So hopefully we can throw a spanner in the works tonight and get ourselves 3 points, get ourselves through to the knockout stages, which would certainly be a success story for us this season. Last time out, we played Celtic and had a 2-0 win. After that, we played Hearts at home, then one of the other games that I said was a big game, and came away with a 4-0 win, really convincing win. Zach Clough and Martin Waghorn were particularly good, and then Zach Clough got himself injured by jumping, and he's out for 4 to 5 weeks. Yeah, the only good thing, I suppose, Alexander Butner is back from injury, which is just as well because Lee Wallace is now injured. If we take a look at our team news for tonight, we have 4 players out injured at this moment in time. Who is it? We've got Joe Garner, who is out, who was injured in a under-20s game. Lee Wallace, Jason Holt, Zach Clough, all missing. So Holt wouldn't have played. Garner probably not. Wallace and Clough certainly would have had some kind of involvement. So a little bit disappointing that we've lost those players for tonight. But we press on anyway. And it looks as though West Ham are going to play the same sort of formation as the first time round with the 4-2-3-1. It will be a challenge. We have been playing a little bit better of late. As you can see, the last 5 games, every player in the starting 11 is at least 7 or higher. As I say, losing Zach Clough is not ideal. And the only striker we have on the bench to replace Clough will be Jack Harper. So getting himself back into the European squad for tonight. Now, in the last game, I rested some players, so I'm going to bring back in Jordan Rossiter, getting back as the register there in the team. Tavernier Butner's fine, Gray on the bench, Cooper and Danny Wilson, centre back pairing, Fodderingham in goals, Benacer in midfield alongside Crowley. I'm still not convinced as to who to play in that role. Tom Lawrence for me should be probably the best player in that position, but Barry Mackay certainly has improved there. He's now natural in that position, and you can see from some of his skills, certainly technique, passing, first touch, pretty decent. Liam Burt has been playing quite a bit, and his skills maybe aren't quite as good, so I probably shouldn't be playing Burt. I think tonight I will probably go with Lawrence to see how that one pans out. If Sasso cannot play, so we'll get Kiernan back on the bench, and Lewis Thompson or Matt Crooks, probably Lewis Thompson, because I think he generally has been the better player. He can also play it right back as well if need be, although Crooks probably can as well. Yeah, he can. Both pretty versatile. Crooks has been doing rather well in training. He's looking for more game time, so we'll see if we can do that. Obviously, this game is pretty important, but we're playing Ross County away from home in 3 days' time. So I think at that point, I'd be looking to probably give Crooks a bit of a run out to see how he does there. But yeah, I think that is the team for tonight. We can put Cooper back to the central defender on the defend role. And yeah, we're good. I think we're sound. Butner 88% for his sharpness, should be able to last the whole game. Scott Gray is there if required. I suppose with Scott Gray, it allows us to go to left back rather than playing Jordan Thompson, who can play as a left. Actually, I'm kind of tempted. I think I'm just actually going to go with Jordan Thompson just in case. Just in case. All right, let's get this game underway and see whether or not we can qualify for the next round. As I say, back at the start when the draw was made, I felt probably second place is something that we could have done. I probably expected Shakhtar to be a little bit stronger. West Ham to win this one, yeah, I would say the bookies are probably right. Both teams, blah blah blah. Right, okay. I think West Ham, just double check, I think they were sitting fourth. Yeah, fourth in the Premier League. Pretty good going from 13 games in. It's fairly close at the top. It's early days still, but yeah, they're doing pretty well. But hopefully we can keep them out of the game. I'm going to get Rossiter man-marking Payet. May have to look at Boutner and Tavernier with the kind of advanced wingers there. I want to close down and I want to go in hard and Payet. Right. Wow, that's a hell of a list. well, as I always maintain, revenge is quite the motive when you give these team talks. Whether or not it would be like that in future versions of the game, I don't know, but certainly Football Manager 17, it's the one to do. And now we need to go and change Rossiter's tactics here, give him his instructions to mark tighter, tackle harder. I really want him to just absolutely crunch Payet, hopefully fairly, and not get himself sent off. Let's go to extended highlights since it's just this game. Been looking forward to this match since the start of the group, because it's, you know, home games are usually where you stand a better chance of winning anyway, and you know, it's the Battle of Britain. It's always a great fixture to have, and it's just good to see the club back in here. Unfortunately, not happening in real life, and in some way off by the looks of things, as Rossiter now looking for some movement in front of him. Taking a bit of an ambitious effort there, and Randolph has had to push that over the bar for a corner, and we'll see whether or not we can get a chance from this corner. Crowley playing it deep towards the back of the post there. Rossiter sitting outside the area. Crowley back again to Rossiter, closed down, not giving any time there. Wilson, will Wilson shoot? No, he won't. Rudden picks it up. No runner there on the outside. Tavernier now goes by his man. Good run from Tavernier, but the cross was lacking somewhat. But we're still keeping the ball. We're still trying to get a chance. And Boutner now finds himself in space. He delayed with a shot there. Three men closed him down, but he still managed to get a shot on target. And we find ourselves with another corner kick. Tavernier will play this in. And it comes back to him. Second attempt now. Looking for Waghorn, couldn't pick him out. Zahavi plays it out to the left to AU, and that's the end of that chance for us. But a decent start, fairly bright. Fotheringham will take the free kick, looking for Butner, who manages to win the header to Waghorn. Plays it inside to Benacer, and that's not a good finish at all. Got his first goal for the club against Hearts in the last game. Wasn't an amazing goal, but he still managed to score. But he's certainly not going to score his first European goal with an effort like that, as Figuli picks the ball up from the rebound from the corner. Kouyaté loses out, but that was a poor clearance. Figuli, Obiang, straight at Fotheringham. And that's a fairly comfortable save for him in the end. Had visions of that just sailing into the corner. Cresswell now loses out to Tavernier. Lawrence Cresswell was out of position. Rudden progressing with the ball down the wing, and I don't know whether that was a shot or a cross. Either way, it ends up in the hands of Randolph, who now sends it up the park looking for Zahavi. Loses out to Wilson. Rossiter forward to Rudden. Still not really getting the jerseys forward, but I mean, they're playing control. I wouldn't expect them to be charging forward. Finds Waghorn. I didn't expect that. And again, Waghorn scoring with his right foot there. Rudden, the youngster, taking on the team on his own. Whether he knew Waghorn was there or not, the ball finds its way to Waghorn's right foot. And he just calmly puts that in. Nice finish. And that's a fantastic start for us. Certainly not going to be counting my chickens at the moment. Games can change, and Rossiter now on a yellow card. I may have to tell him to ease off a bit on the tackling of Pyatt. Certainly a red card here would just be a bit of a disaster, as AU plays it into Kuyate. Obiang forward back to AU again. Xavi has dropped out wide onto the left wing. Kuyate progressing, gets by his man a bit of space. Effort from the edge of the box, and again fairly tame. Fotheringham will be happy if that is the best that West Ham can muster today. And well, here we go, we have a corner halfway through the first half. Creswell plays in, Bonassa with a clearance, and it finds its way back to Creswell. First time cross, Cooper away, Lawrence closes down, but Reid picks it up. Creswell once again, and Kuyate with a wild effort. Certainly if West Ham start to find their shooting boots, we are going to be in trouble. They're certainly getting a lot of opportunities at the moment. But we have the goal that we need, and can we get another here? Lawrence with a free kick cleared. Butner now back to Lawrence. Bennisser in a bit of space, takes a deflection. Randolph struggling to hold on to the ball there. Well, it's not too bad. It's not too bad at all. In fact, one of the things I do want to do actually is keep an eye on the other game, where Bursa Sport at home, or is it Shakhtar? Right, Shakhtar. Actually, that's just going to change, isn't it? It's probably better just to look at the league table and keep an eye on that, as we'll get a pretty clear indicator of what's going on. So at the moment, sitting 7 points clear and only one game left to go. So if the full-time whistle were to go now, job done. As Tavernier picks up a yellow card, so that's the second yellow card of the game for us. As Pyatt takes the ball out wide on the right. Kuyate back to Obiang, wide again to Byram. And completely unmarked there. The header goes off the crossbar, living dangerously. But Tavernier comes away with the ball, and we are still 1-0 up. But yeah, certainly signs West Ham are starting to come into the game a little bit more. But you know, stat-wise, it looks fairly decent. We have had marginally more possession. We have had more shots. We have the goal. Kuyate winning the header again there. Fotheringham saving. Again, fairly comfortable. Certainly the header off the crossbar, he didn't really stand a chance with that. He was well beaten. As that was the chance there. I maybe thought we were going to get it on the way up, but I suppose that's the difference between key and extended. Here we are, Rossiter, 25 yards from goal, unleashes the shot, but it's blocked. Butner picks up the rebound. Lawrence now. Cooper in an advanced position. Butner, Rossiter, will he try again? Crowley on the turn, and that's poor. That's poor. Would have expected a little bit better from him there, the former Arsenal youngster. Pyatt now. Is Pyatt actually playing wide on the left, or is he just drifting? I don't think he is. Number 20. No, he is still playing central. He must just be drifting out into the channels. Rudden on the ball here. Doesn't lose it. Showing a lot of composure, Zach Rudden, for someone so young. As Lawrence now forward, surely will play it to Waghorn. Left-footed effort, and not troubling the goalkeeper at all. You can just see with a little bit more quality in this team that games like this we probably should be looking to win a little bit more comfortably. But certainly from where we were, you know, just under 12 months ago in the game, things are looking pretty good for us. Wilson cutting out the ball forward only as far as Obiang. wide to AU, Tavernier tracking him, and he dispossesses him. Well done, Tavernier. Running is away, using his pace to get away from the central defender, and then poor decision making there. And then now you can see why we've had 8 shots off target, or 3 blocked and 5 off target. Just some poor decision making in that final third. And you know, with some better players, we probably would be a couple of goals to the good. But I can't really complain. The players are doing a job at the moment. And I guess room for improvement. Ideally, I would be telling them to say, look, don't get complacent. You know, you've not won the game, but sometimes people just seem to switch off or get demotivated. It just always seems to work the complete opposite way from you expect. As second half underway, once again, Tavernier dispossessing AU. Tavernier actually, in the last game against Celtic, despite playing really well, only had 33% tackle success, which is pretty poor for a defensive player. But I think he's more valuable to the team here, certainly as an attacking player, as Cooper is going to get himself booked potentially here, as West Ham line up a free kick probably just about 30 yards 25 to 30 yards. Cresswell on the left foot, and he was aiming for the top right hand corner. Fotheringham didn't even move. Either that guy has massive cojones, or he just thought there was no way he was going to stop that. But either way, he didn't move, and the chance was gone. Now Butner on a yellow card as well. Starting to see a little bit of sloppiness in our play as Fuguli gets by Crowley. Now Crowley picks it up. Now we have the chance to break, but that's a really poor ball from Crowley to Waghorn. Played it behind him. West Ham now get their men behind the ball, and the chance perhaps has gone, maybe not. Yeah, it has. Not a good ball from Lawrence there at all. And Crowley now can't lose the ball, and he does. He loses out to Payet. Xavi will go back to Payet. Fuguli has gone beyond Butner into Xavi, and it's a goal. And just as easy as that, the lead has gone. Some slackness in midfield. A little bit disappointed with Crowley losing out there. Just showing a real slackness in our play. As Xavi, strong effort. Fotheringham maybe could have done a little better with that. Nonetheless, it's in the back of the net, and it is 1-1. And it means we are 3 points clear of Shakhtar. So pretty much means we need to draw or do better. Again, well, basically equal Shakhtar's result. That's not true. Actually, we can draw and they can win, and we would have more points. But the game isn't over here, and it's not over there either. And just seeing some of the fitness levels dropping a bit, and players not playing particularly well. Looking at Crowley and Benacer struggling a little bit in the middle of the park. So we're going to have a chance here. I'm going to save the substitution until after this. Waghorn loses out. Crowley wins it back. Waghorn gets back up onto his feet. Rudden, can he score again? Lawrence, saved by Randolph. Benacer playing it back. Probably should have chosen Tavernier there. That was a chance. That was a real, real chance for us. And yeah, I'm just trying to think what the change actually will be here. Very nervous from Benacer, so probably Lewis Thompson as ball-winning midfielder. That's his preferred role. Lawrence has done fairly well today. Really don't have any choice up front other than bringing on Jack Harper. And to be honest, I think Rudden and Waghorn probably stand a better chance. So it's really kind of looking at Thompson, Mackay and Burt for Crowley or Lawrence here. Lawrence has been fairly involved in the play. Crowley hasn't looked amazing, so maybe bring on Jordan Thompson in that role and see if we can get something to materialise from those changes. maybe give the team a bit of encouragement. I wouldn't be too disheartened at 1-1. We've certainly had large number of chances, and let's say with a little bit more of a clinical approach from our strikers, better decision making, we would have found ourselves back in the lead again. That's not a great free kick. Don't lose the ball there, Cooper. Back to Fotheringham. Danny Wilson's at 61%. I don't know why he's so low. He might have taken a knock here. Fotheringham plays it forward looking for Rudden. Cresswell just, I don't know, he must have misjudged that. Lawrence runs into his man, still keeps the ball. Thompson progressing on goal. Waghorn. Butner makes the run through the gap. It's found by Thompson. Byline cross looking for Rudden. It's too far. And Valencia will surely clear the line here. And perhaps West Ham will have a chance here. Zahavi plays it inside to Jachol, to Noble, to Figuli, and it's saved by Fotheringham. And that just goes to show you, you know, you have a chance at one end, and if you're not sharp enough in getting back, you leave yourself open to that counter, and West Ham very nearly punishing us there as Waghorn picks up the loose ball from the corner kick, but he will lose out to Noble, and West Ham once again will try to come forward. Wilson intercepting, Rudden going up with Jones, unable to compete with him there. 10 minutes left. If we were to lose from here, which we might do with Figuli in the box, great save from Fotheringham. If we were to lose from here, I think a win against Bursaspor is what we'd have to do away from home, just in case. I don't think Shakhtar will beat West Ham, but you never know. As Fotheringham catches the corner kick there, certainly West Ham have had the better of the second half, and it's not over yet. They're still coming forward as Cooper wins the ball back and loses it again. I've actually just seen as well here, so Jachol's on, and has Rossiter naturally just moved over to the other attacking midfielder? Yeah, he has. So I was just wondering if maybe he lost that instruction. Yep, cuts out the ball, so he is definitely marking tightly on him. Rudden over the top, Waghorn. What are you doing? Oh, what? All he had to do was chest the ball, take it forward a few yards, goalkeeper was going to come out at you, and you try and finish. Instead, you head it. I don't think that's necessarily down to Waghorn himself in this game. I think sometimes a game just... strange decisions like that, you know, they could chest that there's nobody near them, and unfortunately we didn't get the shot on goal there from Waghorn and the resulting chance. 81 minutes on the clock and West Ham come forward yet again. Good challenge from Thompson there, but we've just given the ball away again. Lucky to get it back. Waghorn should play it to Butner, but he's lost it, wins it back. It's getting a bit scrappy now. Lawrence inside to Thompson, looking for Rudden, possibly offside. Obiang now to Valencia, and he's away. He is away. Jachol, who scored twice against us in the first game, Fotheringham with a save. It's a nervy finish, and certainly it would have been a lot better if Shakhtar weren't winning against Bursaspor. But it is what it is, and you know, we'll see whether or not we can do anything in these last few minutes. Let's just see if we can give it some more encouragement, and may even just bring on Barry Mackay or Burt. Go for Burt. Give Liam Burt a go and see what he can do in the remaining minutes. I think Lawrence has played fairly well, but now it's 66%. To be honest, I don't think the attacking side's the worry. I think it's whether or not we can withstand this here. As Xavi in the box, he's going to score. He does. Oh, that's frustrating. And now it means we're only 2 points clear of Shakhtar, and really just West Ham getting the numbers forward, and Wilson losing Xavi there, and he's finished that well. I'd say for the second half, the way they've played, it's probably merited. And I will be disappointed that we haven't managed to take a single point off West Ham in this group stage. But, yeah, I really thought we could get their 100% record broken, as it's, God, they're still not happy, are they? They still want to get more. I don't want to go overload. I don't want to get an embarrassment here at the end. I think 2-1 is fairly respectable. I'm not happy with it, but Waghorn now, is he going to shoot? He does. Oh, it's just crazy. I mean, he would have been better just running towards the goalkeeper, I think, rather than shooting from there like that. Lewis Thompson, I mean, yeah, these are pretty wild shots, to be honest. And the clock counts down. No more substitutions. Not going to change the formation. It's just, I think one of those games, there's really not a lot we can do here. Lewis Thompson's picked up a knock now as well, so he's going to have the old Basil Fawlty bandage on as we go into injury time now. Cooper, again, easily could have chested the ball there, and he's headed it away, giving away the ball once again. And now we'll play it forward, looking for Waghorn, who cannot get there. Wilson, Thompson, maybe one last chance here. Waghorn is... Honestly, I don't know what to say to that. Just what on earth are you doing? Right, well, that's it. Unfortunately, now we do have to rely on the last game. Yeah, I'm going to tell them I'm not happy, because they were in control that game at halftime and really just let it slip. Zahavi getting a double. When you're up against a player valued at 17.5 million, and he's only scored four goals in six Premier League games for Zahavi. Oops, gone too far. Yeah, not good. Not good, not good. So anyway, let's take a quick look at the fixtures now, as we do each game. If I do the Bursaspor game, it's pretty much going to be every single game in the group stage that I've done, but really, that's probably the game that I want to do. And maybe to vary things up, I'll do the Aberdeen game in the league. Or I might actually, do you know what, I'm probably just after the Bursaspor game just going to blitz it through to like February or something and do a highlights video, because, you know, the reason why the videos are coming out as slow as they are is because it's just finding the time to record it, as opposed to just playing the game. So if I can play the game and just really rattle through these fixtures to try and get through this season, we'll see how it goes. We'll see about the Bursaspor game. I probably will do it. Yeah. Anyway, guys, hope you have enjoyed the episode. If you have, leave a like and a comment. Sorry I wasn't able to beat West Ham. A little bit disappointed about it, to be honest. But anyway, thank you for watching, and as ever, until the next time, I'll see you when I see you.